Now we start chapter 1, module 3. The topic is straight line and circle in the complex plane. We know the equation of a straight line in rectangular Cartesian coordinate system is ax plus by plus c equal to 0, where a, b, c are real numbers, a and b together not 0. Starting from this, we deduce the equation of straight line in complex plane. Then we will find out the equation of a straight line passing through two given points. After that, we consider a circle having center at A and radius r. From this, we will deduce the general form of an equation of a circle. Then we will find out an equation of a circle passing through three given points. In this module, we also see that if the end points of a diameter of a circle are known, we can find out the equation of the circle. At last, we will provide some relevant examples. We first find out the equation of a straight line in complex plane. We take the real and imaginary axis as the axis of coordinates. We know the equation of any straight line in two-dimensional rectangular Cartesian coordinate system can be written as ax plus by plus c equal to 0, where a, b and c are real numbers, a and b are not together 0. So let z equal to order pair x, y. So obviously z bar equal to order pair x minus y. Therefore, we can write z equal to x plus I y and z bar equal to x minus I y. So putting x equal to z plus z bar by 2 and y equal to z minus z bar by 2 y in that equation, we obtain a into z plus z bar by 2 plus b into z minus z bar by 2 I plus c equal to 0. From this, by simple calculation, we get a minus I b into z plus a plus I b into z bar plus 2 c equal to 0. So taking alpha equal to a plus I b and 2 c equal to another constant c 1, we obtain from above that alpha bar z plus alpha into z bar plus c 1 equal to 0, which is the equation of a straight line in the complex plane. Next, we consider an equation of the form beta bar z plus beta into z bar plus k equal to 0, where beta is an arbitrary non-zero complex number and k is any real constant. Now, if z is equal to order pair x, y and beta is equal to order pair a, b, then from above we obtain a minus I b into x plus I y plus a plus I b into x minus I y plus k is equal to 0. From this simplifying, we can get twice a x plus twice b y plus k equal to 0, and that gives a x plus b y plus k dashed equal to 0, where k dash is equal to k by 2. Therefore, the above equation represents a straight line in the complex plane. Now, we will find out an equation of a straight line which passes through two given points. We consider the straight line passing through two points A and B having coordinate z1 and z2 respectively. Let P, whose coordinate is z, be any other point on the line. Then clearly, argument z minus z1 by z1 minus z2 is either 0 or pi. And this is the figure. So, from this it is clear that the line AP and line AB have the same argument or differ by pi. Therefore, z minus z1 and z1 minus z2 is purely real. And we know that if z is purely real, then z bar equal to z. So, from this we can write conjugate of z minus z1 by z1 minus z2 is equal to z minus z1 by z1 minus z2. That is conjugate of z minus z1 divided by conjugate of z1 minus z2 is equal to z minus z1 by z1 minus z2. So, multiplying we get z minus z1 into conjugate of z1 minus z2 is equal to z1 minus z2 into conjugate of z minus z1. That is z minus z1 into conjugate z1 minus conjugate z2 equal to z1 minus z2 into conjugate z minus conjugate z1. That is we get z into conjugate z1 minus conjugate z2 minus z bar into z1 minus z2 plus z1 into z2 conjugate minus z2 into z1 conjugate is equal to 0, which is the desired equation of the straight line. Now, we consider a circle in the complex plane having center at the point C whose coordinate is A and radius R, where A is any complex number. If P having coordinate Z is any point on its circumference, then obviously length of CP is equal to Z minus A. Therefore, we obtain modulus CP that is equal to modulus z minus a and that is equal to r. And therefore, mod z minus a square is equal to r square. We know mod z square is equal to z into z bar. So, from this we can write z minus a into conjugate z minus a is equal to r square. That is z minus a into z bar minus a bar equal to r square. That is z conjugate minus a into z conjugate minus a conjugate into z plus a into a conjugate equal to r square. That is z into z conjugate minus a into z conjugate minus a conjugate into z plus mod a whole square minus r square is equal to 0, which is the equation of a circle in the complex plane. Now, we will find out an equation of a circle through three given points. We suppose that the circle passes through three points P, Q and R having respective coordinate z1, z2 and z3. we also suppose that S, whose coordinate is Z, be any other point on its circumference. Then obviously angle PSQ is equal to angle PRQ. For this, see the next figure. If S is in between P and Q, then from that figure we can say that angle PSQ minus angle PRQ is equal to pi. Thus, in any case, we have angle PSQ minus angle PRQ is either 0 or pi. So, this is our figure. So, here angle PSQ and angle PRQ are same because they are the angles on same rectangular part. That is, we can say that argument z minus z 1 by z minus z 2 minus argument z 3 minus z 1 by z 3 minus z 2 is either 0 or pi. That is, argument z minus z 1 into z 3 minus z 2 by z minus z 2 into z 3 minus z 1 is either 0 or pi. Therefore, we can say that z minus z 1 into z 3 minus z 2 by z minus z 2 into z 3 minus z 1 is purely real. And we know that if z is purely real, then z is equal to z bar. So, from this we can say that conjugate of z minus z 1 into z 3 minus z 2 divided by z minus z 2 into z 3 minus z 1 is equal to z minus z 1 into z 3 minus z 2 by z minus z 2 into z 3 minus z 1. That is, we can write conjugate of z minus z 1 into conjugate of z 3 minus z 2 by conjugate of z minus z 2 into conjugate of z 3 minus z 1 is equal to z minus z 1 into z 3 minus z 2 by z minus z 2 into z 3 minus z 1, which is the required equation of the circle. Just now we see that the equation of a circle passing through three given points having coordinates z 1, z 2 and z 3 can be written as conjugate z minus z 1 into conjugate z 3 minus z 2 by conjugate z minus z 2 into conjugate z 3 minus z 1 is equal to z minus z 1 into z 3 minus z 2 by z minus z 2 into z 3 minus z 1. From this, we can get the condition of coplanarity of four points as z 4 minus z 1 into z 3 minus z 2 by z 4 minus z 2 into z 3 minus z 1 is purely real. After that, we will find an equation of a circle whose end points of a diameter are given, and then we find out the necessary and sufficient condition of two lines if they are perpendicular. We also show that the sum of three interior angle of a circle is pi. So, now we give an example. Find the equation of the circle joining the points A and B with respective coordinate z 1 and z 2 as diameter of the circle. So, let P having coordinate z be any point on the circumference of the circle. For this, please see the next figure. Then obviously the angle between the lines AP and BP is pi by 2. And therefore, argument z minus z1 by z minus z2 is equal to pi by 2. And hence, z minus z1 by z minus z2 is purely imaginary. And we know that if z is any complex number and if z is purely imaginary, then z plus z bar is equal to 0. So, in this case, we obtain z minus z1 by z minus z2 plus conjugate of z minus z1 by z minus z2 is equal to 0. That is, we get z minus z1 by z minus z2 plus conjugate z minus z1 by conjugate z minus z2 is equal to 0. And after simple calculation, we get z minus z1 into conjugate z minus conjugate z2 plus z minus z2 into conjugate z minus conjugate z1 is equal to 0, which is our required equation of the circle. So, this is our figure. So, here AB is the diameter of the given circle, P is any point on the circumference. So, the angle between AP and BP is obviously pi by 2. So, next example, show that two lines with end points z1, z2 and z3, z4 are perpendicular if and only if argument of z1 minus z2 by z3 minus z4 is either pi by 2 or minus pi by 2. Let AB and CD be the two lines and the numbers z1, z2 correspond to the end points of AB and the numbers z3, z4 correspond to the end points of CD. For this, see next figure. The angle made by the line AB with the positive real axis is alpha, and that is obviously equal to argument z1 minus z2. And the line CD makes an angle beta, which is equal to argument z4 minus z3 with the positive real axis. Hence, the two lines AB and CD are perpendicular if and only if argument z1 minus z2 minus argument z4 minus z3 is equal to plus or minus pi by 2. And therefore, we must have argument z1 minus z2 by z3 minus z4 is equal to plus or minus pi by 2, and which is the necessary and sufficient condition for the two lines being perpendicular. So, this is our figure. Here AB, line AB makes an angle alpha with positive real axis. Line CD makes an angle beta with positive real axis. The coordinate of A is z1, coordinate of B is z2, coordinate of C is z3, coordinate of D is z4. So, obviously, the angle. So, here the line A, B having coordinate z1 and z2 makes an angle alpha with positive real axis, and line DC having coordinate z4 and z3 makes angle beta with positive real axis. So next example, verify that the sum of all the three interior angles of a triangle is equal to pi. So we label the three vertices of the triangle as P, Q and R in anti-clockwise direction, and see the next figure. The three interior angles of the triangle PQR having respective coordinates z1, z2 and z3 are given by alpha equal to argument z3 minus z1 by z2 minus z1, beta equal to argument z1 minus z2 by z3 minus z2, gamma equal to argument z2 minus z3 by z1 minus z3. Therefore, the sum of the three angles of the triangle is alpha plus beta plus gamma, that is equal to argument z3 minus z1 by z2 minus z1 plus argument z1 minus z2 by z3 minus z2 plus argument z2 minus z3 by z1 minus z3. And we know argument z1 plus argument z2 is equal to argument z1 into z2. So here we get alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to argument z3 minus z1 into z1 minus z2 into z2 minus z3 by z2 minus z1 into z3 minus z2 into z1 minus z3. And after simple calculation, we obtain alpha plus beta plus gamma as argument minus 1, and which is equal to pi. So this is our figure, triangle ABC, respective coordinate is z1, z2, z3. Angle A is alpha, angle B is beta, angle C is gamma, and we prove that alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to pi.
Rolling.
So next example, show that for any complex number z, modulus z minus 1 by z plus 1 equal to lambda, and argument z minus 1 by z plus 1 equal to mu represents orthogonal circles where lambda and mu are constants. So we have modulus z minus 1 by z plus 1 is equal to lambda. So let z equal to x plus iy. So putting the value of z, we obtain modulus x minus 1 plus iy by x plus 1 plus iy is equal to lambda. And this gives x minus 1 square plus y square by x plus 1 square plus y square is equal to lambda square. And simplifying, we get x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 1 equal to 0, where g is equal to lambda square plus 1 by lambda square minus 1. Obviously, this equation represents a circle. Again, argument z minus 1 by z plus 1 is equal to mu. So this implies argument z minus 1 minus argument z plus 1 is equal to mu. So putting the value of z equal to x plus iy, we obtain argument x minus 1 plus iy minus argument x plus 1 plus I y equal to mu. That is tan inverse y by x minus 1 minus tan inverse y by x plus 1 is equal to mu. We know that tan inverse A minus tan inverse B is equal to tan inverse A minus B by 1 plus AB. So, from this, using this formula, we obtain tan inverse 2y by x square plus y square minus 1 is equal to mu, which gives 2y by x square plus y square minus 1 is equal to tan mu. We suppose that this is equal to nu. So, after simple calculation, we get x square plus y square plus 2fy minus 1 is equal to 0, where f is equal to minus 2 by nu. Obviously, this equation also represents a circle. Since the condition for orthogonality, that is twice g1 g2 plus twice f1 f2 is equal to c1 plus c2, is satisfied by the above two circles, so obviously they are orthogonal. So, at the end of this module, we came to know the equation of a straight line and circle in complex plane or argon plane. We know that the equation x square plus y square plus 2g1x plus 2f1y plus c1 equal to 0 and x square plus y square plus 2g2x plus 2f2y plus c equal to 0 are orthogonal if twice g1 g2 plus 2f1 f2 is equal to c1 plus c2. So, knowing this condition of orthogonality, we can verify in the complex plane also the circles are orthogonal or not. At last, we discuss some relevant problems. For more problems, please see the self-assessment part, and also you can consult any reference books. So, this ends module 3 of chapter 1.